Welcome to DesignFeed's video tutorial on creating mood boards in design. Mood boards are an essential tool for any designer, whether you're working on a website, a logo, or a marketing campaign. They help you to develop and express the personality of your design, as well as provide inspiration and direction for your creative process. In this tutorial, we'll go over the basics of creating a mood board, from choosing your color palettes to organizing and refining your styles. So let's get started. So how do you create a mood board? Step 1. Determine the mood and style. The first step in creating a mood board is to determine the mood and style that you want to convey in your design. Think about the feelings you want your design to evoke, such as happy, playful, serious, elegant, or modern. If you're working with an existing and already established brand, look for the brand personality and tone of voice that already exists or that you wish to change to if you're looking to evolve your brand. Once you have determined the mood and style, choose a color palette that will reflect that mood. You can use online tools like Adobe Color or Color Hunt to help you search for color palettes using keywords with the feelings you want to evoke. When it comes to any form of design, some popular styles include minimalism. Minimalism is a design concept that focuses on simplicity and minimal use of elements. This concept often uses a limited color palette, clean typography, and negative space. Retro. Retro is a design concept that draws inspiration from past decades, often with a specific focus on a particular era. This concept may use retro typography, vintage illustrations, and color schemes from the past. Nature. Nature is a design concept that takes inspiration from nature, often incorporating organic shapes, textures, and colors found in the natural world. This concept may use images of plants, animals, and landscapes. Industrial. Industrial is a design concept that takes inspiration from industrial settings, such as factories or warehouses. This concept often incorporates raw materials, such as metal or concrete, and features a gritty, utilitarian aesthetic. Futuristic. Futuristic is a design concept that imagines what the future might look like, often incorporating advanced technology, sleek lines, and a minimalist aesthetic. This concept may use metallic colors, futuristic typography, and geometric shapes. Step 2. Collect images and textures. Next, gather a selection of images and textures that reflect the mood and style you've chosen. These can be photographs, illustrations, patterns, or textures. You can find images on websites like Unsplash, Pixels, or Shutterstock, or create your own. It's important to choose images that are high quality and visually appealing, as well as relevant to your design project. You can also include typography samples that reflect the style and mood of your design. Step 3. Organize your mood board. Once you have collected your images and typography, it's time to organize your mood board. There are several ways to do this, depending on your design process. You can create a digital mood board using tools like Adobe Photoshop or Illustrator, Microsoft PowerPoint or even Word, or your phone's note-taking app. All you really need is a tool where you can paste your images and write your text as needed. Simply create a new document and then arrange your images and typography on the canvas. Alternatively, you can create a physical mood board using a cork board or poster board. Print out your images and typography samples and then arrange them on a board using pins or glue. Step 4. Refine and edit. Finally, refine and edit your mood board. Remove any images or typography samples that don't fit with the mood and style you've chosen. Make sure the colors and textures work well together and that the overall composition is visually appealing. By following these steps, you can create a mood board that accurately reflects the mood and style of your design project. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial and that you've learned something new. Check out our other videos for more in-depth design knowledge. If you haven't already, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel for more design feeds. Thanks for watching.